Yeah, so the problem with this type of video, it's that it's kind of like a half-truth. So what's being said here is true. The lungs take oxygen in and get carbon dioxide out. And actually, when you hold your breath, a rising level of carbon dioxide is what causes that desire to breathe, or respiratory drive. The problem is, with babies, and especially those who end up suffering from SIDS, or sudden infant death syndrome, the theory is that they actually don't have a normal respiratory drag. So if you have increased levels of carbon dioxide, they may not respond in the normal way and take deeper breaths. So this is the same reason you don't want a blanket or loose sheets to cover a baby's face, because they'll rebreathe carbon dioxide, which increases their risk of SIDS. And then the only other point to remember is, in the United States at least, the risk of SIDS is less than 1 in 1,000. This type of behavior, by doing bed sharing, could increase that risk by 5 to 10 times. So the point is, the AAP really recommends against bed sharing. There are many reasons that parents would want to do it, for bonding or breastfeeding or other cultural reasons, but it's just important that parents have the right information so they can make the decision for their child.